जय श्री राम, जय श्री राम, भारत माता की जय। నన్ను ఈరోజు ఇంగ్లీష్లో మాట్లాడడానికి మీ అనుమతిని కోరుతూ ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు స్టార్ట్ మై మెసేజ్ టు అవర్ బ్రదర్స్ అండ్ సిస్టర్స్. ఈ భారతీయ మజ్దూర్ సంఘ్ తృతీయ త్రైవార్షిక రాష్ట్ర మహాసభలకు ఆహ్వానించినందుకు ధన్యవాదములు. వేదికను అలంకరించిన పెద్దలు, రాష్ట్ర అధ్యక్షులు శ్రీ రవీంద్రరాజ్ వర్మ గారు, తర్వాత మన బిఎంఎస్ క్షేత్ర సెక్రటరీ శ్రీ దొరైరాజ్ గారు సౌత్ ఇండియాకి, ఆల్ ఇండియా వైస్ ప్రెసిడెంట్ శ్రీ శంకర మల్లేశ గారు, ఇతర పెద్దలు, మరి వర్చువల్గా చూస్తున్న, ఈరోజు పార్టిసిపేట్ చేస్తున్న ఆల్ ఇండియా ఆర్గనైజింగ్ సెక్రటరీ శ్రీ సురేంద్రన్ గారికి, ఇతర బిఎంఎస్ పెద్దలకి, బిఎంఎస్ వర్కర్స్కి, అలాగే బిఎంఎస్ యూనియన్స్ ఉన్న యాజమాన్యాన్ని కూడా వందనాలు చెప్తున్నాను. ఇక్కడికి వచ్చిన స్టాల్వర్ట్స్ కూడా ఐ థ్యాంక్ దెమ్ ఫర్ గివింగ్ మీ దిస్ ఆపర్చునిటీ. మై డియర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్, వీఆర్ ఆల్ అవేర్ దట్ ఇండస్ట్రియల్ వర్క్మెన్ ఆఫ్ ఎనీ ఆర్గనైజేషన్ ఆర్ ద ప్రైమరీ స్టేక్ హోల్డర్స్ ఆఫ్ దట్ ఇండస్ట్రీ ఆర్ రిలేటెడ్ యాక్టివిటీ. వీ ఆల్ అగ్రీ దట్ వర్క్మెన్ ఆర్ ప్రైమరీ స్టేక్ హోల్డర్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇండస్ట్రియల్ ఆర్ ఎనీ అదర్ యాక్టివిటీ. ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు బిగిన్ విత్ దిస్. And the Geetam, the song which has been rendered by our friends, has given me a lot of energy and spirit that, you know, we all have common goals. As an industrialist, as a nation, and as workmen, we all have common goal that we create employment, wealth, and happiness to 135 crores of citizens of India. And today, I am extremely happy, and it gives me immense pleasure to be with you on this wonderful event of Bharatiya Mazdoor Sangh Telangana, and a event which happens once in 3 years, which is more important, where we find most dedicated and senior team members who not only guide the workmen, but I have been seeing you also support and understand the industrial issues and problems of industrialists and entrepreneurs. I am indeed proud to be with this, to be part of this event this morning. I was asked to be part of this eminent gathering, both physical and virtual, to speak a few words. To me, my dear brothers and sisters, you are engaged in helping and facilitating economy in terms of growth and wealth creation, which definitely leads to happiness and self-reliance. As mentioned earlier, all the workmen are very important in the progress of any industry. Hence, I have mentioned before that you are all primary stakeholders of the industry and economy. Your sweat, as my brother said, your sweat is converted into wealth, and wealth is converted into happiness. And this is definitely a common goal. I have been in the industry for promoting medium scale. I have been in the industry for over 30 years at various levels in the industry. I myself have been having over 500 workmen for 30 years. Today we have direct and indirect employment of about 1,000 in our group. I traveled over 250 times all over the world, and I have seen right from North America, that is US countries, to Europe, and then our Asian countries in China. But I would definitely say that sare jaise acha sara jahan se acha Hindustan hamara hai. So I have seen this with lot of conviction and courage. I would say that India is the best country in the world, and the spirit what BMS and other workmen and other stakeholders around talk is the same goal, that we should be happy and we should create wealth. India has always been open and tolerant with highest democratic and cultural and family values. We had highest democratic values. My message has always been that all the stakeholders, particularly workmen, have to be recognized for the contribution to the economy, wherein happiness and satisfaction prevails in the livelihood of everybody. This is possible only when there is transparency between the management and workmen, which I believe Bharatiya Mazdoor Sangh, a pioneer trade union organization in the country, and which is a labor wing of our RSS and forms part of Sangh Parivar, is doing amazing and good job in understanding the issues of both workmen and industry in general. Incidentally, friends, I was also an active member of Laghu Udyog Bharati as president, which is again a part of Sangh Parivar, in the service of MSMEs, micro, small and medium enterprises. And we have celebrated 2 years back. Today it is 27 years. Laghu Udyog Bharati understands the problems of micro and small units. And I have been president of this organization for 2 terms, from 2017 to 2021 May. And during which I had to face many issues during COVID and the related problems of workmen and management and others. And we have definitely taken these things to our very well-inclined and open-minded government of India, who have definitely supported everybody to face that. I have always been advocating the best relationship between amongst all stakeholders of any organization, primarily, as I said earlier, with workmen. And I've seriously worked, as in Laghu Udyog Bharati, we have seriously worked on import substitutes. Laghu Udyog Bharati works with 27 to 28 state chapters. And during COVID, we have understood that India has to be self-reliant. And every state where some important products are there have been given a mandate to promote import substitutes. Like, I'll come back to Hyderabad, because Hyderabad has been very popular for engineering industry with lot of defense units. So we took 5 products in Telangana, like dies, molds and fixtures, some aluminum downstream products. So during this COVID period, friends, I had been little active between industry, workmen and government of India and other governments, that we have to be self-reliant in line with call of our honorable Prime Minister for Atmanirbhar Bharat. The government of India, friends, we have seen most deadliest pandemic, COVID-19, which has seriously disrupted personal and economic activity in our country and globally in general. And government of India and respective governments have put all the efforts to ensure that no workman is affected in terms of basic needs of food and shelter. Most generally is health of people. Today, the whole global community appreciates, not only appreciates, they are rather surprised with the efforts of Indian government in containing the deadliest pandemic, COVID-19, very effectively and timely. This is one part. And COVID, which has, I wouldn't say it's a blessing, but it has come as a blessing in disguise for the industry in India. COVID has also taught us many lessons to learn, calling for a movement called Atmanirbhar Bharat, a self-reliant India. In a short span of time, friends, Indian industry has exceeded the expectations of the need of the hour last year and even the second wave also. Today, we are in a position to vaccinate 135 crore people, our all brothers and sisters in the country. In next 6 months or 5 to 6 months, we can vaccinate all 135 crore people, which is a biggest thing where the whole global community is surprised to see the way India has acted very fast. It's a landmark achievement. One other achievement which India has done is, immediately after the first COVID, we were not having masks also. So we exceeded the expectations of the need of the hour by developing and producing masks, sanitizers, other health and medicines requirements. In addition to vaccinations, where our couple of companies, including Biological Events in Hyderabad, has taken vaccination into the global map, stating that we are number one in the world for vaccination manufacturing. And with this, this is allowing 135 crore of people to have vaccination in less than 6 months. In addition to exporting to many countries, we have been very tolerant. We have been very kind enough to give to very various countries by exporting our vaccines from here. Friends, all this is without external help. Everything has been done by India. This being the beginning, our Honorable Prime Minister gave a call that we should be a self-reliant India, self-reliant country. We have understood that we can do everything. We have done defense equipment. We have done missiles. Now we have done medicines, everything. So today we are second to none, and we can be global superpower in coming days. So our Prime Minister has given a call that we should be self-reliant India by manufacturing and producing our own products and discourage imports and stop imports if possible. So let us all come together and see that, you know, in Laghu Udyogvardi, we started a movement called Utpat Samoha, where we are discouraging imports and encouraging the local talent and industry and infrastructure to produce import quality material. That means instead of importing good quality, you produce import quality, which can also go as exports. We have started in Laghu Udyogvardi, where all the workmen and the unions have been supported us. As I mentioned before, friends, our country, India, has been working at the highest value systems in all walks of life, giving utmost importance to democratic rights and equality amongst all segments of citizens, allowing freedom of speech, freedom of press, and freedom to follow any faith and religion in our country. As such, every Indian born in India is an Indian irrespective of any religion or caste or creed. We are all Hindutva. We are all Hindus. Or we are all Indians. Friends, the government of India has announced various schemes to help and facilitate manufacture import substitutes, particularly for MSMEs, which are engine for the growth of any economy in the world. Today, Indian MSMEs are the engine for the growth of our economy, and certain definitions have been changed to give better and bigger exposure to MSMEs in the global market and also produce import substitutes. We can be a global superpower in next 25 to 30 years. We can be what in 30 years, which China was about 35 years, nothing. And we can be global superpower in next 25 to 30 years if the same momentum continues amongst us. The owners and the management and the employees are the partners in progress of the industry. Industrial development is very crucial for national development. We are all aware of it. Harmonious industrial relations ensure steady growth of industrial sector, and we are definitely very transparent with all the workmen. As an entrepreneur also, I tell you that I have been personally transparent, and many of my friends and colleagues in the industry are always thinking about the welfare and benefits of the industry, of the workmen. Mazduri alone is not adequate reward or remuneration for mazdoors. They deserve recognition and respect. They are entitled for a share in the fruits of industrial growth and economy and prosperity. Employees' participation in decision-making is the new order of the day. This should encourage at all levels. While bonus is mandatory, ex gratia payments and employee stock options are also welcome to see that India becomes a manufacturing hub for the globe. Employee directors on the board are also considered as highly desirable. Self-development and skill development of employees is important. Indian government is spending huge amount and introduced skill development centers all over the country, giving opportunity and stipend to youth of India to become skilled workers for not only their better future and also for better India. Friends, we'll continue our value systems, unlike the hypocritic Western countries who have allowed China to grow in the last 32 years, particularly when the democracy was killed about 32 years back in Tiananmen Square. Workers, students, and other people have advocated and fought with the Chinese government that they need democratic rights. And on 4th June 1989, we all know that were killed and imprisoned for just for asking, just because they have asked for democratic rights. At that point of time, the Western nations, which always advocate democratic rights, have started investing in China, despite knowing that there are no democratic rights. They started investing in China and made it a superpower today. Today everybody is really shocked with the growth of China. Now, I don't know how many of you have gone to China and how many have not seen or not visited. Friends, whatever you think about China today, I am 100% guaranteeing that it is 100 times more than about your imagination. If you are imagining this, they are 100 times bigger. If you allow another 5-7 minutes, I'll take on China things and let you know. Yeah. So they have allowed China to grow by transfer of technology, engineering, knowledge, and lot of money. 35 years. This is exactly coinciding with the death of democratic movement in China. They want to protect their own, countries and rule as dictator. China has always been an economic and political assertive natured country. They have, in fact, bought all the nations which are surrounding India. I'm going to tell you little facts about that. So, friends, Western countries starting from US to Europe, maybe Australia, New Zealand, and some more Middle East countries have contributed to the growth of China and made it a superpower today. And they are now today, the country is not in anybody's hands. They become too big. Last month, friends, this is an important issue. Last month, the German Chancellor, Mrs. Angela Merkel, goes on to say that we European Union allowed India to become pharma leader in the world. How can you say that? We have invested our money. We have struggled. We made pharma industry number one, just like IT industry. She tells that European Union allowed India to become the global leader of pharma industry. This is not fair. You have allowed China to become the biggest manufacturing country in the world. And now when we are doing ourselves, mind you, with proper democratic rights, proper freedom of speech, we have grown in pharma industry. And you are telling that we allowed India. Why didn't you say that we have allowed China to grow? You have no guts to say, because a lot of money is stuck in China. You are depending for all the products with China, and you can only talk about India because we're tolerant. So we have a lot of tolerance. Friends, yes, we'll continue to have tolerance, but let us be smart enough to become engineering leader in the world. So this is not right. So all developed countries, in addition to transfer of technology, have invested a lot of monies in China in the last 30-35 years and allowed it to grow, making it a super economic power in the world. While politically, they're arm twisting the countries near us, in ASEAN countries and India, but economically they have become superpower, friends. This was not fair, and allowing one country and allowing them to dictate is not fair. Though they call it a socialism, there is no socialism there. Friends, I would like to take another 5 minutes and close it. Sorry for your, and thanks for your patience. We speak about Atmanirbhar Bharat, but what are the challenges we'll be facing with China on account of their political and economic assertiveness? While COVID-19 has emphasized and reiterated self-reliance by stopping and discouraging imports, we should concentrate on exports also. India demonstrated its might and ability by addressing its requirements during the pandemic. With the pandemic, the Chinese backlash, the whole Western country has got antagonized due to its assertiveness globally. There is huge opportunity for Indian enterprise to make a self-reliant India and be a global player. This is a big challenge to India, since China has grown multifold and become global economic dictator. Its greed economically and high-handedness politically makes it far more difficult for Indian enterprises to reach out to global businesses, but we are not going to fear. This is mainly because the West, though highly antagonized, cannot ignore China, since they have been dependent on China for 30 years, and now with large investments being stuck and parked in China in its companies and industry. With huge cash and wealth, China has pushed, this is an important point, friends, with huge cash and wealth, China has pushed more than 150 countries into a debt trap of $5 trillion. I would explain how much is a billion, how much is a trillion. $5 trillion is 3 crore 75 lakhs crores. 3 crore 75 lakhs crores. అంత డబ్బులు, అంత డెట్ ఉంది 150 దేశాలకి. వాళ్ళందరూ చైనా దగ్గర, చైనా మాట వినవలసిందే, చైనా నుంచి సరుకులు కొనవలసిందే, చైనా మాట వినవలసిందే. అంత డబ్బు ఇచ్చి చైనా హ్యాస్ డెట్ ట్రాప్డ్ మోర్ దెన్ 150 కంట్రీస్, విచ్ ఇన్క్లూడ్స్ అవర్ నేబరింగ్ కంట్రీస్ ఫ్రమ్ శ్రీలంక టు బంగ్లాదేశ్ టు నేపాల్. దే ఆల్సో కరప్టింగ్ ద ఆపోజిషన్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ నేబర్స్. Pakistan is, we all know that they have been ally of China. So this is the time that we have to open our eyes, become one, the management, workmen, government, at what all stakeholders have to realize that we don't need to, you know, discuss or debate or talk, but we should, our common enemy is somebody else or something else. So China has long, friends, we were talking that Iran has been our good friend, but 3 months back, there is an agreement between China and Iran that China buys all the oil of Iran and China supplies all the material what Iran requires. 25 years agreement is legally signed. Where is your friend? Saudi Arabia has signed for 50 years, 50, that they would buy oil, they would buy things from Saudi, and China gives its materials to them. So we don't have anybody now as friends. So China has long-term arrangements with Iran, Saudi Arabia, and other Western Asian countries, in addition to the Western countries. The Western countries, who were supposed to be the torchbearers of leaders for democratic rights globally, have contributed and supported to the growth of China, Chinese global dominance in the world. Now, wherein democracy has been suppressed by the Chinese government, as I said, on 4th June 1969 at Tiananmen Square. While we call it a coincidence or reforms, China has grown manifolds after Tiananmen Square, with the so-called protectors of democratic rights worldwide. So friends, we have to be self-reliant. And then I would just take another 2 minutes. Our neighbors, all our neighbors, Sri Lanka, a port has been built by China with 99-year lease, which is only 290 kilometers away from Indian border. So when Sri Lanka cannot pay the money, China will have its, in fact, last month or 45 days back, one big ship has gone to China's port with full of radiation material, which is required for making nuclear weapons. Even the Sri Lankan government was not knowing that what that ship was carrying. Ship was carrying radiation material and it was sent back. So we are very vulnerable because all our neighbors, Sri Lanka, a port, and a lot of space has been given to China to develop port and a port city. Bangladesh, and Pakistan, we know, has been depending on China. All our neighbors, on an average, owe about 60,000 crores to China in the way of debt and grant they have been receiving in the last so many years. So these people are just waiting how they repay to China or they have to succumb to Chinese pressure and tactics. Turkey and Malaysia are also indebted to China. So friend, I come from aluminum industry. I would only compare the size of the industry and China's strength globally. Aluminum in the world, there is a capacity of 7 crore tons, 7 crore, 8 crore tons of aluminum prapanchamlo undi. And China is having 52%. China is having 37 crores of aluminum, whereas India is having 36 lakhs, 10%. The remaining is by Russia, by Denmark, and other European countries. So 50% of the aluminum metal is with China. That is, raw material is with there from China, and they will, there is a ban of exporting raw material from China to other countries because they would like to use vallu raw material cheyakunda vallu raw material export cheyakunda only value added products chestaru ante 3 crore 60 lakh aluminium ni vallu aluminium extrusions gaani aluminium sheets gaani aluminium chair gaani aluminium furniture gaani oka ton ki meeku 100 employment ivochu oka ton aluminium ki meeku 50 mandi ni employment ivochu ఆ టన్ తీసుకెళ్లి మీరు ఎక్స్పోర్ట్ చేస్తున్నారు ఇండియా నుంచి. వీ హావ్ 3 అల్యూమినియం ప్రొడ్యూసర్స్, నాల్కో, హిండాల్కో, వేదాంత. వీఆర్ ఎక్స్పోర్టింగ్ మెటల్ బట్ వీఆర్ నాట్ ప్రమోటింగ్ అల్యూమినియం కన్సంప్షన్ ఇన్ ద కంట్రీ, వేర్ యాజ్ వీఆర్ ఇంపోర్టింగ్ అల్యూమినియం డౌన్ స్ట్రీమ్ ప్రోడక్ట్స్. ఇట్ జస్ట్ లైక్ బ్రిటిష్ రాజ్, యు నో, వీ యూస్ టు ఎక్స్పోర్ట్ రా మెటీరియల్ అండ్ బ్రింగ్ ఫినిష్ గుడ్స్. వీఆర్ డూయింగ్ సేమ్ థింగ్ నౌ. సో వీ హ్యావ్ టు ఓపెన్ అవర్ ఐస్, కమ్ టు ద కామన్ టేబుల్ అండ్ సీ దట్ రా మెటీరియల్స్ ఆర్ నాట్ గోయింగ్ అవుట్ అండ్ పుట్ ఎ ఫుల్ స్టాప్ to the dominance of people who have become very big in the country, in the world now. So friends, I would only send, I am not so big to give a message to you. Whatever little I have known, I spoke to and shared with you, and you are all stalwarts about the industry. I would only say that let there be transparency between the management and workmen. We all come to on the common platform and see that our coming generations, if we allowed some other country to grow in last 30 years, let us take less 30 35 years for us and grow, be self reliant, produce export products and make our future generations happy to live in this world. This is what I would like to say. For this we have, as I heard from the our Geet of Bharatiya Mazdoor Sangh, every word what my friend has spoken or sung was is the common goal of an entrepreneur. We need to produce, we need to create wealth, we need to generate employment. It is a common goal of entrepreneur, workmen, government, everybody. So we have a common goal. Small things we need to put aside and see that. I would request Bharatiya Mazdoor Sangh that kindly see that next 35 years belongs to India, and as an entrepreneur, whatever little we can do, we will do it. We have to be number one in next 35 years, Sunday. And for this, I take leave and I thank you everybody for giving me this opportunity. And I hope that I was not boring. And then, you know, whatever little, in fact, I can speak another 10 pages, but then, you know, I really respect your time and then your 2 days program. It was a real pleasure that I'm here because I have been attending CIA meetings. I have been attending industrial promoter meetings, but this is the first meeting where I feel that I came back to my family, because workman is my family. I always treated them like it was my family. So I am with my family, and thank you very much for this opportunity.